Hello, YouTube friends. Dr. Teresa here with you again today, giving you the latest update on the dwarf seahorse tank. Things are finally stabilizing in the tank. The water parameters are much closer to what we want them to be for seahorses. So I thought I would just give you a little update and observing their behaviors, how they're doing. I'm just searching the tank with the camera to see who we can find. There we go, there are a couple right there. You can see there's plenty of baby brine in the tank. And they're pretty active. There's another one back here. And I'm just scanning the tank to see who we can see. They're really good hiders. So sometimes we have to look closely to find them. Well, there's a guy back there. He's a little hard to see. See if we see any on the coral here. And they've been hanging out a little bit more on this reddish artificial plant here. I don't see any right now. One of the things I did want to point out, and then just do a quick demonstration on my daily maintenance. I'm getting into a good routine now, seeing how to keep the water the best quality. Oh, here's another one up here. You'll notice when you look at the artificial plants and sea fan here that there is starting to grow some algae, and there's even a little bit growing on the coral and the bottom of the tank. I don't see that as a bad thing. For me, that's telling me that the water's stabilizing. We're out of the more dangerous levels of water parameters and into the safer ones. I still want to keep those nitrates under control, but the fact that algae is growing is telling me that, all right, we have higher levels of nitrates. And I mentioned in a previous video, I'm going to just let the algae continue to grow on the back wall. You might see a little bit on the back wall there. There's a discoloration. That's the beginning of algae starting to grow on the back wall. That will actually help keep the tank stable because the algae will absorb the nitrates. Also, I want to keep algae in the back because I do have copepods that I have been adding to the tank. So here's a rock that was in the copepod tank, and maybe once or twice a week I swap out a rock. I put the rock that's in the seahorse tank and put it in the copepod tank that's down below. And today I just wanted to do a quick update, show you the seahorses, give you a chance to enjoy them, and then a quick daily maintenance. It takes me about 2 minutes. I have been trying to sight them. And just show you my little maintenance. This takes me about 2 minutes each day, and I do have my mini magnetic cleaner for the sides of the tank. Notice that I'm not really worried about the back of the tank or where the sponge is. Those are areas that aren't seen very well anyway. But it's just another place where I can allow algae to grow, and it will just work towards keeping the aquarium all that more stable. And notice how quick and easy this is. This is the perfect size magnetic cleaner. So So I usually try to make a sweep in one direction, for example, horizontally, and then go back again and do a vertical sweep. This seems to be working very well. And then I'll just get this side here. It's pretty fast, as you can see. And this particular brand that I'm using, it's nice because if the pieces come apart, the part that's inside of the aquarium will float, so I don't have to dip my hand in there. So I'm going to put the magnet back, and then I'm just going to show you my very quick method of vacuuming. I'm going to move the light fixture so that I can open the hinge, and then I'm going to use a rigid hose attached to just a regular aquarium hose. I have a little container here, and I'm going to start a siphon process. I like this rigid hose because it's just the right size to pick up particulate matter and detritus, and without taking out too much water at one time when I just want to do a very simple cleanup. So I have to do the old-fashioned getting the siphon going. And there it goes. So I just hold onto the container, and then I just use the aquarium hose, the rigid hosing, and where I see buildup on the bottom of the aquarium, just go back and forth with the siphon. And one of the things I really like about this, besides the fact that it doesn't take out too much water when I'm not really interested in doing a larger water change, it really doesn't disturb the tank too much, and I can navigate into small spaces and just have minimal movement in the aquarium. I try not to move the ornaments around too much because the seahorses in nature, they get used to a habitat with their fixtures being in a certain place. And when they establish their visiting places where they socialize or even search for a partner, they use those places as cues for their socialization. So other than that rock that I swap out for the copepods, and I do put it in the same area, I really don't play around too much with the location of the decorations. Any change I would make would only be for my pleasure, just to see variety, and honestly, it doesn't matter that much to me. It might matter more to some people than others. But for the seahorse's sake, I try to keep it stable because they seem to have their favorite spots, and not just the favorite spots, but they seem to be their favorite spots at different times of the day. So the lighting that I have on here now is a gradual increase and decrease. I'm going to go ahead and stop the siphon, and it kind of mimics their natural light exposure in nature. I'm ready to just replace the water with some fresh prepared seawater. And so that change in lighting signals the time of day to the seahorses. And I notice that they are more active during certain times of the day, and they tend to like to do their flirting rituals in the earliest lights and then when the lights start coming down again. So that's the latest on the seahorses. Things are going well. I have hatching and feeding process down pretty well now too, so I'll probably do an update on that in the future. And I'm hoping now that things are going very well, I'll continue these mini water changes, vacuuming each day, and then probably once a week do a 10 to 20% water change to keep everything in control, as well as rinse out some of the filter media. But everything is going well, and hopefully we'll be seeing some more antics of flirting and maybe even some seahorse fry in the near future. I'm just going to go ahead and focus on the seahorses a tiny bit, just for your pleasure of enjoyment. I just find it so relaxing to watch the seahorses with whatever they are doing. Thank you for joining me today. It's always good to see you and have you with me. Thank you for following and helping me enjoy my series in refining dwarf seahorse keeping. Take care.